We are going to do directional overcurrent protection, and I am using IEEE 4-bus system. So always remember to use the copy and never use the default system. And let's modify the model by deleting bus 3 and the transformer. But first switch to edit mode and just delete these two and directly connect this transmission line to bus 2. Now let's just enlarge the size of bus 1 and bus 4 by simply dragging them down, and let's connect what is connected in between them in a parallel path by just simply copying it down like this. Now let's make the system voltage uniform. So I'm going to enter 12.47 here and okay. And let's change the voltage of this lump load as well. And I'm going to change the kV rating to 1730 also. Now let's connect a static load at bus 2 and bus 3. And I'm going to enter 10 MVA. For each. Now let's enter this short circuit reading of the grid. And I'm entering 100 MVA and 17x by R ratio. So far so good. So this is my system in which grid is serving lump load and the two loads are served by the two parallel paths, and the lump load has got a backup supply. So let's see if the system is possible, and also to know the currents I am running the load flow analysis. I want to know the current and show units. So for bus 1 it is 495, so 500, and for bus 2 and 3 it is 50 amperes, and after this I'm going to run the fault analysis, and let's show you something that is peculiar or particular to this case. So if I put a fault at bus 2, then you would see this grid is serving this fault and not serving the lump load, and neither the load connected to the bus 3. So this is, and the fault is getting served from both the paths. So I will have to have the directional protection over here, so that if the current flows in the reverse direction, then this portion is isolated from here. So if this is isolated, then this service will continue like this. So now let's switch to edit mode. And I am going to put CTs here. Now the CT ratio. No, let's connect the OCR first. So I'm putting all the OCRs, connecting all the OCRs with the CTs. OCR is overcurrent relay, and let's connect the circuit breakers as well. Now, let's enter the CT ratio. The rating was 500, so for the normal load current, it was 500, the normal load current, so rating would be 500 to 5, is to 5, and designation B to glass, and further run, it is also 500. And here it was 50, and designation B2. And so far so good. Now for the overcurrent rating, I'm again going to do fault analysis to know the least fault current. So if I put the fault here, the maximum fault current is, or the minimum fault current by applying 9 to ground fault, is 3.18 kiloamperes towards the bus 2 or from the bus 1, and least reverse current is 0.909 kiloamperes. The reverse current is 0.909, and let's see if it is the least current. 3.58 kiloamperes is the least current, so I am going to put the fault at bus 4 as well, so that I may know the forward current is least or not. So if I'm putting the fault here, I am getting the forward current as 1.91 kiloamperes, and 1.91 is obviously lesser than 3.18. So for forward direction, the least current is 1.91, and for reverse direction, it is 0.909 kiloamperes. Now, for the pickup values of OCR, we have found out these least current values. Now we are going to select Siemens JS7601, and it has overcurrent protection function. I am disabling the overcurrent here. I am selecting instantaneous protection. Now for the pickup, divide the fault current to the load current, and I got 3.82. This OCR as well, same ratings and same Siemens 7SJ601, and pickup is 3.82. Okay, now okay, I'm going to add the circuit breakers as well. Add circuit breaker to in this one. Now for other OCRs, I am selecting LSTOM P139 here. And I am providing protection and just the face. I am deselecting every other protection, ground and negative sequence. And in this, I have selected reverse direction. Now for the pickup. Okay. Add circuit breaker in the output, circuit breaker 3. Okay. Now for the other one. Select LSTOP P139. Oh, okay. I am first adding this circuit breaker. Now select LSTOP P139. And deselect every protection and just let instantaneous remain. Select directional protection as well. Okay. Now the output, and yes, I have added circuit breaker 4 here. Let's see if this is working. Star protective device coordination, let's put default at bus 2. Then CB1 and CB3 should operate. And CB3, which is a directional relay, is operating. So if I put a fault at bus 3, CB2 and CB4 should have operated. Let's see, we might have made some mistake. Maybe we haven't given the direction in the OCR. So, okay, click 67 here and give the direction reverse. Okay. Now it's the protective device coordination, put fault here, and CB2 and CB4, they are tripping. And the service continues from the upper path. Now at bus 4, CB1 and CB2 should trip. So they are tripping. Hope you understood.